Welcome to the notes on similar polygons. So that word similar, okay, it's just kind of how it sounds. It means they're a lot alike, but not exactly the same. Where congruence is exactly the same. Similar means kind of like same shape, different size. We'll get into that. So dilation, that's a term you might use. It's when there's an enlargement or reduction. It refers to if the similar figure is bigger or smaller. Okay, so what is similar figures? Here's what you got to know about similar figures. Number one, there is a shape with all congruent sides. Have to have that. And then second, all proportional sides. And then all the sides have to have that same proportion. That's why we just did, we now know what proportions are. So since what is the scale factor then? Well, the scale factor is just the ratio of the corresponding sides. Again, there's that idea of corresponding sides, the sides that match up. So scale factor is just kind of how those, the ratio of the corresponding sides. So over here, all right, here is a picture of, all right, two congruent figures. All right, now our similarity statement. We know they're similar. All right, it says right here, all right, this is our similarity statement. You can see right here, just like congruent statements, the orders of the letter matter. The orders of the letters matter. Okay, and there's our congruent similar symbol. It's just like the congruent, but just without the equal sign. Okay, so let's find the scale factor of A, B, C, D to D, E, F, G. Well, since we know they're similar, we pick any two sides to compare. Oops, sorry. Let's compare AB to DE. So AB's right here. All right, DE's right here. Again, be careful. The pictures sometimes deceive you. You got to look at that similarity statement, make sure they match up. So if AB is 5, DE is 10. So we always want to reduce those fractions or those ratios. So the scale factor is 1/2. Okay, now let's take the scale factor of DEF to ABCD. Notice this, the order switch, that's really important. So let's pick two different letters. So let's do the last two, FG to CD. So now order matters. I'm going from the bigger triangle on the right here, FG, to the smaller CD on the left. So here it is, okay? When I set it up, it's gonna be FG is 24, CD is 12. So when we compare them this way, the scale factor would actually be 2. Okay, so the order that you're comparing the shape does matter. In one way, it's getting bigger. The other direction, it's getting smaller. So be aware of that. Okay, let's get to some problems. It says determine whether the polygons are similar. If they are, write a similarity statement and give the scale factor. So steps. First thing I do is, are all the angles congruent? They can't be similar if all the angles aren't congruent. You can see by our tick marks, they are. So that is yes. Okay, so next, we need to find the ratio of the sides, all of them, all right? All have to be equal. Just keep that in mind. So, depends, doesn't matter which way you compare, but I'm going to compare the first triangle, kind of the top triangle, to the bottom triangle. Okay, so when I'm setting this up, just remember, it doesn't matter which way you go, but you have to be consistent. So every time, I'm going to do top over the bottom. So now, which side to pick? Well, shortest side goes with shortest side in the other picture. You don't know which the exact similarity, but you can always match up the short side to the short side of each. So on this triangle, the shortest side is AC. So on the top, I put 8. Well, what does that compare to on the other triangle? Well, on the other triangle, AC, the shortest side is 10 right here. So that's FD. So 8 over 10. Now, we always want to reduce that if we can. So 8 over 10, that reduces to 4 over 5. So every side better have that same ratio if it's going to be similar. Let's do the middle side. All right, 12. All right, and then that compares to what's the middle side on the other triangle? Well, that would be 15. So 12 over 15. What is that reduced to? Well, 12 over 15. 4 goes into 12, 4, or 3 goes into 12. 4 times, 3 goes into 15, 5 times. So it's 4/5 again, so 2 for 2. Don't assume anything, got to try that last side. Our longest side is 16 on this triangle, and our longest side on the other triangle is 20. So 16 over 20. Okay, does that reduce? It does to 4/5. Since all three have the same scale factor, we know that they are similar. So they are similar. The last thing we need to do is write the similarity statement. So here we go, all right, the first triangle. Doesn't really matter how you label it. You have to make sure the second one matches up. So I'm just gonna call this ABC, ABC. and that's going to be similar to, all right, what are we going to call the other triangle? Well, I started at A. That's the angle with the two tick marks. So I got to start at D. So triangle D. All right, then I went to B. All right, the medium length. So I'm from D, I got to go to E. And then obviously F would be last. So that congruent statement or similarity statement is extremely important. Okay, another example. All right, two more. Similar polygons. Now they tell us they're similar. So you're going to have to determine if they're similar. Then when they tell you they're similar, we got to determine the missing values. Well, the key to this problem, again, is consistency. Which way are we going to compare? I'm going to compare this triangle on the left, all right, to the triangle on the right. So when I set up my proportion, I want to make sure everything is kind of L to R. Again, you can go the either other way, but it just has to be consistent. So if I want to find X first, okay, X is right here, all right, on this smaller triangle. Well, when I set my proportion up, okay, I know it's going to be a proportion, and X is on the right triangle. So I know that's going to be in the bottom somewhere. What we want to do is we want to find the two sides that correspond that we know both values. So I know that BC is 5 right here. But what are the second two letters? DC, oh, on this triangle, it's 3. So those two values compare. So those have to be in our ratio. So I'm going to write that in. So left is 5 to 3. Well, that's going to equal, well, if I want to find X, that's going to be my right triangle. So that goes in the bottom here. Which piece on the other triangle, that's DE, the first two letters, well, AB, that's right here, so it must be over 8. Once you've set it up, you know how to solve them, just cross multiply. So 5x equals 3 times 8 is 24. So when you divide each side by x, you are going to get, or excuse me, divide each side by 5, you're going to get, that's going to be 4.8. All right, so that is your value for X. Decimals are okay. Now, one more triangle, then we're done. All right, says right here, separate the triangles. This is really key. So triangle ABC, I'll do that in red. That's this little guy right here, ABC. So when I redraw that thing, all right, here's A, B, C, and here's my values, 2, Y, and 1. Now, the bigger triangle, I'll do that one in blue, ADE. That's this whole thing, and this is why drawing it's really important. So here we go. You'll see why in a second here. Here's A, here's D, here's E. Well, what's the value of DE? Well, that's this length right here. That's 6. Now, the sides is where it's really important. What is the value of AE, this whole distance right here? Well, it's not just 3. It's 1 plus 3. So this whole thing is 4. And then this side isn't just X. It's actually the 2 plus the X. So we're going to call this side 2 plus X. So when we set up our proportion, I'm going to go small to big. You could go big to small, but we just have to be consistent. Now I'm going small to big. So in your proportion, all right, you have to use the two sides where you know the values. Well, I know here that AC is 1, and that goes with the 4 on this side. Okay, so 1 to 4 is going to be in both our proportions. So now, which piece do I want to solve? Well, if I want to solve for y, let's pick y first. All right, well, y is the small triangle. It's going to go here. What side corresponds to y in this triangle? It's 6. And then we just cross multiply. So 4y equals 6. Divide each side by 4 and get your answer. All right, so y is going to equal 1.5. And then now to find x, we're going to use that same proportion of 1 to 4. Oops, 1 to 4, and that's going to equal, all right, now if I want to find X, which is right here, all right, 2 plus X, well, that's going to go in the bottom of my proportion, 2 plus X, because again, this bigger one goes in the bottom, which side corresponds to that in the smaller triangle? It would be 2, now cross multiply. Again, when you've got two terms down here, make sure to distribute. Now, in this case, it doesn't matter, it's going to be 1 times, parentheses, 2 plus X, okay? But we don't have to distribute, and that's going to equal 8. All right, at that point, we solve for 8. But you can see how important setting up these proportions for similar figures is going to be.